the official Grey Witch. And I have a moment to do a video, so I thought I'd do one. Got you all set up on my new fancy schmancy tripod. There we go. And I got a couple questions on a topic of coming out of the broom closet. People wanted like tips and stuff for coming out of the broom closet. So I consider myself out of the broom closet. I'm still rather selective about who knows my religion and who knows that I'm a Wiccan and that sort of thing. Obviously my parents know, my boyfriend knows, I'm sure some of the other family members know. My coworkers know, but that took a while. I have bumper stickers on my car, so like a lot of other people know. But even if they see that, like they don't exactly know exactly what I believe. You know what I mean? Like they don't know all the things that I do, what all goes into being a Wiccan and all that good stuff. So I guess I'm selective about who I let into like the inner circle or the inner knowledge of what all I do. I'm still kind of getting over a cold, so that's kind of why I sound a bit like a smoker. But when I first started out, I was very secretive. Like it basically was all confined to this bookshelf in my room. And like I didn't want my mom to know. I didn't really want my friends to know. And I spent that time basically just learning and reading and just kind of studying and that sort of thing, which is basically what I did for the first 6 months before I decided that this is what I wanted to do, this is what I agree with, this is what I believe, and that's when I did my initiation ritual. It was the first magically thing that I had done at that point. And that's when I basically officially started my path. That was in 2010. And then a few months after that, in like, I think it was like August or something like that, is when I started saving up money to get the materials to make my Book of Shadows. So that thing was a work in progress, and that took a good, like, I want to say 2 months of saving up babysitting money and going to Hobby Lobby and slowly accumulating all the materials and making it bit by bit with the help of my friend Eowyn Hawthorne. And that was quite a process. So the first person who knew was my friends. Obviously, Eowyn Hawthorne, my friend Taylor, a couple other of my friends knew. And we all kind of like were into that whole Celtic-y, magic-y, dragons and whatnot thing anyway. So like it wasn't that big a deal to them. And usually friends are more understanding anyway. But when I told my mom, I know that she was very reluctant to accept it. She's like, you're just going through a phase. Wicca isn't really a religion. Like, you really shouldn't be reading that stuff, because she's a rather hardcore Christian. And she's kind of a hypocrite, because she likes to read astrology and she kind of believes in astrology, yet she's very, very Christian and she doesn't like tarot and all this other stuff. So like, Mom, tarot is kind of like astrology, like it's another form of divination. Like, but after her reaction, I didn't talk to her about it at all. I kept it to myself. I didn't share any of my beliefs. I didn't I don't preach anyway, but I didn't just share anything with her. And she went on being her preachy self, like, blah, God says this, and the Bible says that, and, and, after a while, I got very tired of, not expressing my beliefs. Like, I felt like I was denying myself, and I'm still going through this process of living openly, like, completely open, and fully embracing my path and living it day to day. And it's kind of hard to do that, especially when I have a stressful, I'm a server, and it's a very high-pressure stress job, and I work, like, 40 to 50 hours a week, and and then this move and everything, so it's like it screwed up my whole daily schedule of like meditation and whatever, and so I'm trying to like incorporate Wicca into every aspect of my life, and it's a process. But at the time, just by not expressing my beliefs, that was in a way denying who I am, and I didn't like that. Like, I had grown in my spirituality enough to know that I wanted to express my beliefs and this is who I am. So I covertly expressed my beliefs in a third person sense. Like, we would be watching a show and Mom would say something rather rude about, like, this culture or this culture's beliefs or that sort of thing. And, or it would be like some religious show or something, and it would say something about like, we'll just say divination. And I would say, well, some people believe this. And like, some people believe that. And like, this is why they believe that sort of thing. And like, this is their logic behind believing in that. And so it would be my beliefs, and I would be expressing that, you know, other people have these beliefs too, but I wouldn't directly correlate myself with those beliefs, you know what I mean? But, like, I knew that these were my truths, and so I was still exposing my knowledge and my beliefs in a third-party sort of sense. That way, I could express my point of view without riling an argument with my mom. Then there came a point where I got brave enough to wear a pentacle. And it was the first time I wore a pentacle, and it had been like, I want to say a year since I started reading and studying about Wicca. And I felt like I could, you know, I felt comfortable enough that if anyone should have, you know, a few questions, I could answer it. And my mom was outside talking with my neighbor, who is also very, very Christian, and also my neighbor's friend, who they both went to the same church and stuff. And mom was talking to my neighbor and my neighbor's friend, and I came up to join the group because mom and I were supposed to go somewhere, so I was waiting for her to be done. And my neighbor's friend pointed to my pentacle and said that's the devil's symbol. And I started shaking and I kind of panicked a little bit, but I told him, no, that's not what this means. This is actually a symbol of the five elements, earth, air, fire, and water, and spirit, interlocking as they are interconnected. And that was the end of it. And, like, he just kind of shut up, and my neighbor kind of, like, looked at me like, so, like, do you believe in that? Like, is that what you believe in? And I said, yes. And he wanted to have a talk with me. He's like, we should talk about this. I want to have a discussion with you. And this is where you need to listen to your instincts. And something told me that he was not going to listen to anything that I said, and that he really just wanted to try to convert and to basically shove his beliefs down my throat. And so I told him, you know, not right now, maybe another time. I don't really feel comfortable talking about it right now. Like, I didn't want to talk to him about it ever, and that's fine, but I didn't want to talk to him about it. And I kept telling him, no, I'm good, thanks. No, I'm okay. We don't need to talk about it, because it's really none of his business anyway. And I would say the first tip after this whole big spiel is to know your boundaries. Know what you are comfortable with. Know what you are comfortable exposing to other people. Trust your instincts. You do not have to explain yourself to anyone. You do not have to tell anyone about your beliefs or about what exactly you do. And if the second tip would be to trust your instincts. Know when someone is actually going to discuss your beliefs, like, you know, in a actual discussing sense, and not in a, I'm going to tell you my beliefs and your beliefs are wrong and we're not going to have a civil discussion about it. Like, you know what I mean? Because I've actually talked to, I had one of the regulars at my job ask me, like, point to my pentacle. Because I wear, it was a bigger one when my neighbor saw it, but I wear this one at work and sometimes it'll pop out of my shirt. I tend to keep it hidden at work just because I don't really like to discuss religion at work. Religion and politics should never be discussed at work or bars. Just saying, like, they're no-nos. Just because religion and politics tends to create a division in between employees, and you really need to have like a teamwork kind of mentality there, so it's really best just to not talk about religion or politics. Anyway, so he had noticed my pentacle and asked me, oh, are you Wiccan? And I was kind of surprised, like, you knew, like, he knew what that was, and I was like, yeah. He was like, oh, that's so cool, like, like, do you believe in blah, blah, blah? Like, what exactly do you do? Like, it was kind of nice that he knew that not everyone is the same. And so I felt comfortable enough to, like, oh, yeah, like, we have Sabbats. I worship a god and a goddess. Like, it's basically just, like, looking at an almighty divine, but separated into male and female aspects and that sort of thing. Like, you know, we had a legitimate discussion about what I believe. And I felt comfortable enough, and it was a civil discussion, and he still comes in, and he still, like, hangs out and stuff, and he was very nice and civil, and those are good discussions. I had another coworker at a different job who was, we'll say that she's more spiritualist. She was kind of pagan, but she didn't really affiliate herself with any specific, like, pagan religion. And she, we had very deep spiritual discussions, and you'll find people like that too. But as far as coming out of the closet, I would say to just, it's going to be a process. It's not going to happen all at once. For me, it's happening in stages. Know who you want to know about your religion. Know your boundaries, know what you're comfortable with discussing. Like, if you don't feel comfortable talking about your personal rituals and stuff like that, don't talk about it. Don't talk about it to other pagans, don't talk about it to me, don't talk about it to your loved ones. Like, just, that's between you and deity. If you don't feel comfortable talking about it, don't. And, no one has to know about that personal stuff. Like, you are in charge of how open you are. And so when you feel ready to wear your pentacle outside your clothing, to get that, you know, Ankh tattoo or whatever, when you feel comfortable to do that, then do it. Now, with being more open, you're also exposing yourself more to the negative feedback of others, just like my neighbor. And you have to be prepared to deal with that stuff. If you are not prepared to deal with any kind of negativity, then I would still keep it to yourself. Because I was so scared. I was so scared of people calling me devil worshiper and condemning me. And, like, I'm still a little bit scared of people, like, vandalizing my stuff or, like, keying my car because of my bumper stickers and stuff like that. But it just comes with the territory, and you have to be prepared to deal with it. I have put a protection charm around my car to protect me from vandalism, to protect me from car crashes, that sort of thing. It actually worked. I have like had near misses. I wear my Pensacola all the time because it's like I feel like it protects me and it keeps me connected. Also, it has a moonstone to keep my emotions in check because I tend to be a bit moody. Sometimes I will have like stones with me that like give me courage and stuff. Like I had a citrine with me during my job interview to give me courage. Take precaution if you feel like you need it. But I mean, really, it depends on what you're comfortable with when it comes to coming out of the closet. Hopefully one day I will be like Tiptoe Chick and Charming Pixie Flora and Mother Moon Pagan and all these other witches out there who live it day to day. I want to do that. I want to be like that. I want to just don't care, do my own thing, just like have be like very obvious that that's the witch house. That's where she lives. She does magic in there. And that's my goal, but I'm working towards it. I am living with my boyfriend. He's letting like I have incense burning all the time, which I didn't get to do at my dad's house, but that's mostly because he just didn't like the smell. Like it would mess with his sinuses and stuff like that. But my boyfriend loves incense, so I get to burn incense all the time. He was very understanding when I said that we had to move in the early April because Mercury retrograde is actually happening like right now-ish, now that I think about it. And that it was bad. It was basically bad energy to move in during the Mercury retrograde. And so it was funny because like I had forgotten for a while and we were discussing like when we can move in because we were getting closing to lease time. And he was like, "Well, we gotta do it. Is that gonna be too late? Because Mercury retrograde and all that good stuff." And he was being very sincere about it. And I was just like, "Oh yeah, that's happening." And it just made me laugh that he remembered. So I am slowly getting to that point, and I hope you guys will eventually get to that point too. Don't lose hope. Just get that courage. Keep learning. And just know your boundaries. I've said that so many times, but that's really all I got for you guys. So, in the next video, hopefully I will be talking about what I think a witch is, because I also got that question too. So I will see you guys in the next video. Have a good day and bless you be.